siku kumi ni siku kumi, si mwezi kumi. Kwa hivyo ni siku chache. Itachukua jukumu na mikakati za watu wengi ambapo watajihusisha na kuwatafuta na kuwasemesha na kuwafikishia habari hawa vijana pahala popote walipo.
They are part of the many reactions after Interior Cabinet Secretary Joseph Nkaiseri granted amnesty to youth who had been lured into joining Al-Shabaab. The youth have been given 10 days to denounce the militant group, after which they will be forgiven.
The amnesty be a true amnesty without any victimization, threats or any of the kind.
SUPKEM says that majority of the youth joined the terror group out of desperation and lack of employment opportunities.
When there is an element of insecurity, the cost of resources that is spent on insecurity is so high. If we can only get a quarter of that money to support these young people, then we can actually do a great deal for the peace and stability of this country. And finally,
Interior Cabinet Secretary Joseph Nkaiseri directed that the youth should report to county commissioners in Nairobi, Mombasa and Garissa. But SUPKEM says that they should report back to reputable village elders, sheikhs, imams, priests and officials of human rights who will then escort them to the county commissioners.
Na hawa pia pahala popote walipo wanaweza wakatafakari waone kweli hii ni msamaha wa ukweli na turudi majumbani kwetu. Na tujihusishe na jamaa na taifa letu na tujenge taifa.
Friday this week, SUPKEM has directed imams and sheikhs in all mosques countrywide to announce the amnesty.
According to SUPKEM, Muslims across the country and members of the Somali community are being blamed unfairly on having links with the Al-Shabaab. Due to this, they want the government to review the list of some people and organizations that have been linked to the terror group. Sharon Baranga, NTV, Nairobi.